Good morning once again. Welcome. I'm Teacher Bernard Ochieng, a teacher of chemistry. We are going to continue with our chemistry lesson on sulfur and its compound. Yesterday we did see how sulfur is extracted, and we also saw some of the allotropes of sulfur, and we also discussed the way sulfur behaves when it is heated. Today we want to discuss the uses of sulfur and also other areas. Now, the main uses of sulfur, one, is used in the manufacture of sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is manufactured in large scale through contact process. And another use is sulfur is used in the manufacture of sulfur drugs. If you can recall, we have drugs which are, for example, malaria drugs. If you go to hospital, you are being asked whether you are allergic to sulfur drugs, or meaning that some of the drugs are manufactured using sulfur. And then we also have another use here. Sulfur is used to make dyes, for dyeing the cotton, particularly in the cotton industry. We also have another use of sulfur, vulcanization of rubber. We know that rubber is always very soft, and for it to be tough, it has to be heated using sulfur to make it tough, harder, and less resistant to temperature. You can imagine the motor vehicle tires, they are tough, they are resistant despite the friction. We also have another use of sulfur is used to make bleaching agents, particularly in wood pulp. It's used to bleach wood pulp in paper industry. We know that the papers we are using are bleached, and indeed that's why they appear white, and they're bleached using the sulfur, the product sulfur. Another one is also used in making carbon disulfide. Carbon disulfide is one of the reagents that is used in the factories. Another use is, it is used in the manufacture of fireworks, matches that we normally use at home, and also the gunpowder. Those are some few uses of sulfur. So we are going to go to the next area that we need to look into, is the oxides of sulfur. Sulfur generally has two oxides, sulfur 4 oxide. This one here, the formula is SO2, sulfur 4 oxide, and sulfur 6 oxide, which is SO3. They are very important. We are going to look at them and their uses later. Now, if you look at this sulfur 4 oxide, how it is being prepared in the laboratory. There are several ways of preparing in the laboratory, but one main way of preparing in the laboratory is this action of dilute hydrochloric acid on sodium sulfide. Any sulfide can react with an acid, particularly hydrochloric acid, to form sodium chloride, sulfur 4 oxide, and water. And we also have another one, action of copper on hot sulfuric 6 acid to form copper 2 sulfate, water, and sulfur 4 oxide. There is a diagram here that I wanted us to discuss on laboratory preparation of sulfur 4 oxide. This sulfur 4 oxide, first of all, as I've said, you are seeing the hydrochloric acid is being poured in a round bottom flask, and then the sodium sulfate down here. This heat is applied to ensure that it speeds up the rate of reaction. That is the role of the heat here. So this sodium sulfite reacts with hydrochloric acid to form sodium chloride, sulfur 4 oxide, and water. So sulfur 4 oxide will follow through this tube to this part of the setup that contains sulfuric 6 acid. This is concentrated sulfuric 6 acid. The essence of using this sulfuric 6 acid is to ensure that the gas that is obtained from where it is generated is dry. And being a colorless gas, it will follow through this delivery to this tube, and then it will be collected. Being heavier than air, it is collected by downward delivery or upward displacement of air. The air that was inside here is being displaced upwards. So being a colorless gas, you may not be able to see whether the gas jar is full, and that's why you see this potassium dichromate 6 soaked in a filter paper and placed at the mouth of the jar. The moment you see this acidified potassium chromate 6 change the color from orange to green, that one is an indication that indeed this gas jar is full. So the gas is being dried using concentrated sulfuric 6 acid and then collected by downward delivery. Downward delivery, reason being, it is denser than air, and that downward delivery, sometimes we refer to it as upward displacement of air. As I've said before, that we also have copper and sulfuric acid. Now, in place of sodium sulfate, you can use copper and sulfuric acid to obtain the same product. That is how we prepare sulfur 4 oxide in the laboratory. I've said there are two ways. One is action of sodium sulfite and hydrochloric acid to form sodium chloride, sulfur 4 oxide, which is a gas, and water. This is what is collected in the gas jar. Still, when preparing sulfur 4 oxide, you are not supposed to use nitrific acid. You can remember we used hydrochloric acid. You can use hydrochloric acid here or sulfuric acid, but you cannot use nitrific acid. The essence is nitrific acid is a strong oxidizing agent and will easily oxidize sulfate ions to sulfate, and that is the reason why it is not preferably used. And I was also saying that for us to confirm that the gas jar is full, the potassium chromate 6 paper will always turn green from orange. And another caution that we need to take care of is the aspect of poisonous nature of this sulfur 4 oxide. That is the reason why it is being carried out in a fume chamber or in an open space, but fume chamber is the best. So we also have other general ways of preparing sulfur 4 oxide. One of them is by heating sulfur directly to in oxygen to form sulfur 4 oxide. Sulfur is yellow, and the moment you heat it in oxygen, you burn it in oxygen, you get sulfur 4 oxide. Another way is heating, or you heat sulfides or iron sulfide in oxygen to form iron 3 oxide and sulfur 4 oxide. The same way you can collect the sulfur 4 oxide that is obtained from that reaction. Some of the physical properties of sulfur 4 oxide, as I said before, it's a colorless gas. But in as much as it is colorless, it has an irritating choking smell. You see, when you choke the saliva, that is how the moment you inhale this sulfur 4 oxide, you'll be choked because it has that characteristic. Again, it can be liquefied under pressure, only 3 atmospheres required, and then the gas turns it liquid. Again, as I've said, it is denser than air, that's why you see it's 1.5 times denser than air, and that is the reason why it is collected by downward delivery or upward displacement of air. Again, you notice that we do not collect it using our water method. Reason being, you can imagine one volume of water will dissolve 700 volumes of sulfur 4 oxide. And that is the reason why it is not collected over water. Reason being that it is highly soluble in water to form the acids. The acids that are formed are sulfuric 4 acid and sulfuric 6 acid. Again, if you look at the boiling point of it, of sulfur 4 oxide is negative 10 degrees Celsius. And imagine the melting point is also negative 72. And that is the reason why sulfur 4 oxide exists in gaseous state at room temperature at 25. Imagine before you reach 25, it has already turned into gas. So at negative, so imagine it is boiling at negative 10. Negative 10. And also, it also melts at negative 72. So at 25 degrees, obviously, it will exist in gaseous state. Before we continue and see properties, we are going to discuss properties of sulfur oxide, both the acidic properties and other properties in our next lesson. Thank you for now and keep listening. Thank you.